各位弟兄姊妹，慕道的朋友们，平安。
Welcome, brothers and sisters and friends.
感谢主，我们信友堂2023年的福音营，经过疫情以后，相隔五年以后，在我们同样的地方再次进行了。
Praise the Lord, the gospel camp after 5 years, including COVID, is resumed.
感谢主啊！其实呢，我们2019年还有一个同工营，其实我们离毕这个营地呢只是四年。
Actually, we used to have another camp called Coworker Camp in 2019. Therefore, we just left here 4 years.
但是这四年里面呢，这个营地呢，其实这个学院里做了很大的翻修。我们今天享受了一个更美好的环境。
But thanks be the Lord, there is a big renovation in this college, so we enjoyed even a better place now.
感谢主。每一年我们教会的福音营呢，我们都有一个传统，都会做一件 T-shirt。我们这一次做的是鲜黄色的。
So every year we have a good tradition that in the gospel camp we're going to have a new T-shirt. This year we have a yellow T-shirt.
因为这次好像这个 T-shirt 特别的闪亮，所以呢，我今天这次也打破常规了，作为讲员也穿着 T-shirt 上台，和我们的翻译一样。
So because today's T-shirt is very shiny and good, so Pastor Hong decided to take this shirt on to be the speaker.
所以呢，我也鼓励大家在营地时能穿 T-shirt， 尽量把这个我们的营地的这个闪亮的颜色显露出来。
So Pastor Hong encouraged everyone to take on this yellow shirt, which is shiny everywhere in this camp.
如果你怕冷的话呢，多里面多穿点，在 T-shirt 里面多穿点，再把 T-shirt 罩在外面。
If you feel cold, you are welcome to take another hoodie or some clothing inside of your T-shirt.
你实在不行，没地方好塞的呢，尽量把前面解开。
If you really don't have other clothing, you may open up your other clothes.
让人家看到你是里面的确也穿了 T-shirt。
Let everybody see you really wear this T-shirt inside.
感谢主，因为这个是本来说是这个 T-shirt 制作是比较晚，但是。交传到他做了最后的努力啊，没想到的一举成功，在差不多2-10天里面全完成了。
Actually, it is really very tight. We don't have enough time to make this shirt ready, but thanks be the Lord, Pastor Zhao really put effort in it, and it's done within 10 days.
今天呢，我在这里开幕式里呢是要欢迎各位啊，我们今天一起来到这个营地。
So here we are welcoming everyone here coming to this gospel camp.
在这个营地里呢，最重要的一份东西呢，就是这个营地手册。
The most important document here is this handbook.
所以希望每个人拿到以后呢，一定要赶快把你的名字和房号写在上面。
So please write down your name and your room number here on your book now.
Yeah, 否则的话你一般丢失以后没有名字了，人家就也不知道是谁的，就无法还给你。
Otherwise, if you lost your book, nobody know that's yours.
所以这个手册呢，我们也感谢啊，这个我们总是张达弟兄作为行政助理呢，他是及时完成的。张达弟兄在那里啊，我们现场感谢。
We thank the Lord for Brother 张达 to make this handbook happen.
大家知道，这个就是我们教会呢过去的手册。一上来呢，我们有一个祈祷文，是为我们的教会所预备的。所以弟兄姐妹，我们带着祷告的心来到这营地啊，我们把祈祷文，希望大家每个人在心里面都发出同样的祷告，看一下。
The first important thing is the prayer of our church at the first page in this handbook. Let's have a heart of prayer for this camp.
因为福音营本来就是一场属灵的征战。
Because the gospel camp is a spiritual warfare.
所以我们只有靠着圣灵的大能才能得着圣灵的果子的。
So only when we rely on the power of the Holy Spirit, we may get the fruit of the Holy Spirit.
所以我们很感谢主啊，最近前期这一个礼拜多来，我跟师母也是在家里祷告，为我们来到我们当中的所有的慕道的朋友提名祷告。
So it is very thankful during this week, the wife of Pastor Hong prayed for everyone not yet believed in this camp, so the Lord may save them.
所以我们今天大家知道福音营里面的主角最重要的参加的成员就是我们的福音朋友。
So we know the most important people here are those are not yet believed.
所以我希望我们教会的各位同工们啊，来都认识我们的福音朋友们。
So Pastor Hong invite every pastors and co-workers to know every new friends in this camp.
你看，如果我们的手册我们翻到第十四页啊。
If you open up to page 14, page 14.
这个十四页上面的每一个福音朋友，我们的慕道朋友啊，都用他的星号啊，用星号把他们标记着。啊，如果已经觉知还未受洗的，就是一个十字架的符号标记着。啊，这就是我们的啊福音朋友在我们中间啊，我们要特别的在主里欢迎他们，为他们献上祷告。
We find the names of every not yet believed new friends on page 14. They are especially noted by the star mark. Let's have a heart of prayer for every one of them.
所以我们现在第一，我们请所有的慕道朋友，我们的福音朋友，就是你还没有受洗成为基督徒的，在我们中间聚会的，你都站起来接受我们的热烈欢迎，好不好？请。
Now,Please stand up, everyone not yet believed. Please stand up.
Please stand up.
Please stand up. Everyone not yet believed in Jesus. Please stand up.
接受热烈欢迎，接受热烈欢迎，欢迎欢迎欢迎，感谢主。好，大概还有一些人没到，对不对啊？一共我数了一下，起码有16位啊，我们的慕道朋友在我们中间，啊，感谢主。下面呢，我在想呢，在这里啊，这里给大家介绍一下我们的整个主席啊，这个安排呢是在。第二页上面大家看到。
So now Pastor Hong will introduce the time schedule. It's on page 2.
我们呢整个的这个福音营的信息一共是四场。
So we have 4 messages in total.
今天晚上是第一场。
Tonight is the first message.
明天上午是第二场。
Next, tomorrow morning is the second.
明天晚上是第三场。
Tomorrow night is the third.
后天上午是第四场主日敬拜。
On Sunday morning is the fourth.
我们的第一场和第四场是中英联合的。
The first and the fourth are combined Chinese and English together.
我要特别指出，这是我们福音举办以来的首次的特别有双语同在的这个福音营。
So this is the first time we have bilingual gospel camp.
因为我们当中有我们的英语堂的年轻的弟兄姊妹们，现在呢，这英语堂弟兄姊妹们，他们当然自己有聚会，同时他们也在里面担任很多的服事，特别是我们儿童事工的一些，他们以及事情等等，在我们中间是一个不可缺少的有机组成部分，所以请他们都一起站起来，英文堂的接受我们的欢迎。
So all English congregation, please stand up.Thanks to the Lord for their congregation, their service on piano and everywhere. Thanks to the Lord for them.
感谢主啊，他们来参加的都是英文堂的最积极的一部分成员，他们都在英文堂都是同工，在这里又做了很大的协助工作，同时他们也抓紧利用这一次营地机会，他们有自己的信息。
So we have co-workers and stored the core workers in English congregation here, and they will have their own message.
我们呢，这个除了这个四场信息呢，我们还有两场的讨论，都是两晚上，今天晚上一场，明天晚上一场。
Including tonight, we will have small group discussion tonight and tomorrow night.
时间都在这上面，还有一个呢，就是特别的为福音营所预备的，就叫做问题解答，是明天下午4:15到5:30进行。
And we have a special Q&A session tomorrow afternoon.
所以我们求主呢，使用这些信息来帮助我们，来一起为主征战。
So let's pray that the Lord will make use of all these messages so that we may fight for the Lord.
所以我们今天呢，在这里呢，我下面呢也请大家翻到第十五页，我要对我们所有这次福音营的同工们表示在基督里的感谢。
So let's open up to page 15. Now Pastor Hong will give thanks for all the co-workers for this camp.
大家都知道啊，他们的电话也摆在这儿，为他们特别献上感谢啊！这就是我想在这里呢，我在基督里为我们今天我们的福音能够成功在这里顺利的开始，都离不开各位同工的一起的摆上，一起的在这里的合作，求主来赐福给我们个人手中的工，让我们这个福音营能够在这里。完完全全达到主交给我们的荣耀的任务。下面呢，
各位弟兄姐妹、来宾朋友，平安，
平安。
在我们进入到营地的时候，第一个晚上是非常 exciting 的， OK， 所以你可能睡不着觉。但是我们来到营地的最终的一个 first priority， first 的你要认识的就是耶稣基督。我们人生第一重要的首先是认识那一位创造世界宇宙还有赐给我们人类生命的主宰，这个才是最重要。当你认识了他以后， Your life 在他的手上，所以你就保险了。今天我们的主题，今天的营会的主题歌就是真神羔羊。那我们一同起立，我们来敬拜真神羔羊 O Lamb of God。 Second time we sing in English。
上帝儿子分界无瑕，金杯在天立天作为，他上挣脱罪恶世界，甘愿成为神的羔羊，
真神羔羊，宝贵羔羊，
我深爱慕圣洁羔羊，求你宝血来洗净我，耶稣基督真神羔羊，神的爱子被钉十字架，受着鞭挞
亲爱的救主耶稣基督，我们来到你的施恩宝座前。主啊，如果你不是向我们显现，不是你亲自用你生命的之道来启示我们，我们人犯罪以后的人是不可能来到你的面前，也不可能能够见到你的容面，因为我们见到你的时候就是我们死的时候。主啊，今天我们在这个世界上看见许多许多的怪现象，这并非偶然，就是因着我们人类的犯罪的结果，以至于造成这个世界看上表面的繁华，表面的吸引人，但是结果我们没有一个人可以逃脱死亡。但是今天你在这个福音的营地要向我们宣讲你那永生之道，我们人类唯一的盼望，因为你起初创造亚当夏娃的时候他们并不会死，因为你是那位永活的主。但是当我们的始祖犯罪以后， 我们与神的生命的连接的关系就破裂了，以至于我们成为亚当夏娃的后裔，也罪就进入到这个世界，死亡也进入了这个世界，并且来掌权。没有一个人我们不怕死的。但是今天你借着这个福音的营地向我们来宣讲你的好消息，这个好消息不是在我们地上能够吃好穿好，我们的过这些的岁月静好的日子，因为再岁月静好我们人都会过去，就像你所说的都会归于尘土。但是今天我们是有盼望的，求主你高抹洪牧师的口，使他所传讲的这个生命的信息能够真正打动我们每一个人的心，也包括在座的每一个慕道朋友的心，让他们能够听闻你的真道，以至于灵魂苏醒过来，以至于能够正确的回应你。主啊，我们把这三天的营地全然仰望交托在你的手中，求主你来做我们的生命的主，做我们的王，来保护我们，赐福给我们。我们这样的祈求祷告感恩是奉靠主耶稣基督的名求，阿们。请坐。在以赛亚书55:6-9这样说，当趁耶和华可寻找的时候寻找他，相近的时候来求告他。恶人当离弃自己的道路，不义的人当除掉自己的意念，归向耶和华，耶和华就必连续他。当归向我们的神，因为神必广行赦免。耶和华说，我的意念非同你们的意念，我的道路非同你们的道路。天怎样高过地，照样我的道路高过你们的道路，我的意念也高过你们的意念。让我们来唱一首诗歌，非常感人的诗歌。作者在这首诗歌当中在寻找，他没有出路，看见这个世界是没有出路的，是这么样的绝望。但是接下来怎么样呢？让我们一起来唱。不会唱的没有关系，你就听，跟着慢慢来唱。好，请思琴。我是空谷的回音，四处寻找我的心，问遍溪水和山林，我心依然无处寻。我是空谷的回音，四处寻找我的心，问遍溪水和山林，我心依然无处寻。啊，我曾经多盼望生命不是情，一声叹息最真痛，放弃一切的追求，任凭潮水带我走。眼泪带不走。 但愿这首诗歌能够真正打动我们每一个人的心，我们已经蒙恩得救的人可以有许多许多的见证，神是怎么样保护我们带领我们。但是今天我们的慕道朋友，你会跟我们一样蒙受这个福气。今天洪牧师第一场的信息就是亚伯拉罕之约。大家，我相信你没有读过圣经，也听过亚伯拉罕这个名字吧？神预备女人的后裔。那我们首先来读神的话语，大家可以看着这个字幕上面，创世纪三章十四、十五节，大家一起来，请。耶和华神对蛇说：“你既做了这事，就必受诅。”比一切的牲畜野兽更甚，你必用肚子行走，终身吃土。我又要叫你和女人彼此为仇，你的后裔和女人的后裔也彼此为仇。女人的后裔要伤你的头，你要伤她的脚跟。耶和华的使者第二次从天上呼叫亚伯拉罕说：耶和华说，你既行了这事，不留下你的儿子，就是你独生的儿子，我便指着自己起誓说：论福，我必赐大福给你；论子孙，我必叫你的子孙多起来，如同天上的星，海边的沙。你子孙必得着仇敌的城门，并且地上万国都必因你的后裔得福，因为你听从了我的话。在启示录十二章一到六节，请献出大异象来。有一个妇人，身披日头，脚踏月亮，头戴十二金的冠冕。她怀了孕，在生产的艰难中痛呼叫，天上又现出异象来，有一条大红龙，七头十脚，七头上戴着七个冠冕，它的尾巴拖拉着天上星辰的三分之一，摔在地上，龙就站在那将要生产的妇人面前，等他生产之后要吞吃他的孩子。妇人生了一个男孩子，是将来要用铁杖辖管万国的。他的孩子被提到神宝座那里去了，妇人就逃到旷野，在那里有神给他预备的地方，使他被养活1260天。感谢神的话语，神的话语是应当称颂的。所以我们很多慕道的朋友，可能你读了这一段话，到底是怎么回事啊？那就请洪牧师来向你们宣讲神的美好的福音和创世神的计划。
好，感谢主啊，谢谢刚才黄长老带领我们大家敬拜读经。
Thanks be the Lord for Elder Huang leading us to praise the Lord and read the scripture.
的确是的啊，今天呢，这个福音营的主题就是看那神的羔羊。
Indeed, the theme of this gospel camp is Behold the Lamb of God.
这个亮丽的这个我们的 T-shirt 啊，我们的 T-shirt 衫上面已经把这个主题打上来了。
On our T-shirt, we have seen this theme clearly.
因为他要除去世人的罪孽。
Because God will take away the sin of the world.
所以呢，今这次呢，我这个福音的三讲，主日敬拜 是另外的一回。但三讲里面呢，都是围绕着看那神的羔羊进行主责的。
So all the first three messages are all surrounding the theme of Behold the Lamb of God.
都是用神的话语做我们今天所有的正道的根基。
We are all focusing on based on God's word.
第一讲，正如刚才黄长老已经说过了，是怎样上帝借着和亚伯拉罕立约。为我们预备女人后裔的到来。
So the first message is we're going to see how God, through making a covenant with Abraham, prepared this grace of salvation through the offspring of the woman.
而第二讲是摩西律法是要引我们来到上帝所预备的那个女人后裔面前。
The second message, we're going to see the Moses law will lead us to the offspring of the woman.
那第三讲就讲这女人的后裔来到世上，她是谁呢？就是我们的耶稣基督。所以看那神的羔羊，耶稣的新约。
So the third message, we're going to see this offspring of the woman is indeed Jesus Christ came to this world. Therefore, we see, behold, the Lamb of God.
所以我们的经文信息从全本圣经出发，从第一篇的创世纪到最后的一篇启示录，都要把这上帝要赐给我们的他圣洁的羔羊让我们来认识。
So our scripture will start from the very first book of the Bible, Genesis, all the way through to the end, the Revelation, and we're going to see how God prepared this lamb for us.
这个信息对我们已经信主的基督徒来讲是让我们的信仰更有根基。
This message for us who has already believed in the Lord will make our foundation even more firm.
对于我们还在寻求神的我们的慕道友，就像空谷的回音这首歌所唱的，我在这个世界上彷徨，我在寻找，那么你就要来到这位上帝的圣洁羔羊耶主耶稣的面前了。
But if you have not yet believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, and you are wandering in the world, you must come before this Lamb of God.
所以今天我在这里要讲的这个信息，其实就是我当年要信主的时候最想的，要完整的，不从人的口，从神的启示里面得到的一种根基。这就是我今天要给大家预备要讲的。
So this message is very special because at the beginning when Pastor Hong believed in the Lord, he wanted to preach this message just based on the word of God. And now he got this opportunity.
所以我说我们这儿的慕道朋友来听我这个侍奉啊，不是在我26年前、30年前的那个福音，我也在那时候开始讲了，现在再讲，你们是更有福的。
So, new friends, you are not yet believing in the Lord, but you are very special. You are not hear the message Pastor Hong preached 30 years ago. Now you are going to listen a very new message.
那好，我们今天呢就这样子啊。我们首先就是整个福音信息是完整的，要把耶稣基督在我们当中宣讲出来，这是福音的根本。
So the gospel message is totally about Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is the foundation of our message.
首先要问大家一句话，什么是福音呢？
So first of all, what is the gospel?
首先要讲什么是福音以前，我也讲什么是世界呢？
So first of all, before talking about what is the gospel, so first, what is the world?
我们作为每一个在这里的活的世人啊，大部分人只收到一种信息，这个信息是来自世界的信息。
So we as human beings, we probably just receive one kind of message, which is the message from this world.
我们从人的所写的各种书籍里面，各种媒体的这种传播当中，啊，或者我们各种的教科书上学习的，都是从世界上来的信息。
So we receive a message and information from the world through textbook, through media, through people's theory.
所有这些信息从来没有要求我们去信它。
None of this message asks us to believe it.
只是摆在我们面前要我们学习它。
They are just there for us to learn from it.
这最好的知识，人类的最好的知识，是让我们人能够在世界上做事情的那些知识，就是让我们成为我们沉重的功课。
To the best of this knowledge is to let us learn how to live a life in this world and how to do things.
这就是我们在学校里从小到大从老师父母谆谆教导我们要努力学习的那种知识。
These are the things we learned when we were young in the school. The teacher teaches how to live a life based on those knowledge.
这种知识里面的最好部分就是有关科学技术知识的那部分。
The best of this knowledge is about science and technology.
这种知识学了都有上帝的美意，让我们了解这世界是怎样运作的，使我们能够更好的来管理，来在这个世界的自然当中为我们创造各种各样的需要。
Of course, there is goodness of learning this kind of knowledge because God wants us to know how this world works so that we may better manage this world.
所以就是说这最好的知识也是给我们今天在上帝的普遍的恩典里是我们这一生关于我们这一生所有用的知识。
So the best knowledge we can learn is just about this life.
这种知识让我们如果用现代化来讲就是所谓的各种各样的科学知识。
This kind of knowledge, if we say in modern language, is about scientific knowledge.
但是离开了这些对于科学技术的真正的这种知识以外，我们还创造了其他知识，比如说人文科学、社会科学。这两种知识里面大部分都是垃圾，都是渣滓，都是把我们引到这个世界的毁灭当中去的。
So besides the scientific knowledge, there are other types of knowledge, for example, social science knowledge and other kinds of knowledge. They are leading us betray to some bad place.
比如说我们从中国大陆来的最一种政治课要我们上的所谓共产主义的理论学说，就是这种垃圾中的最坏的垃圾了。
So for example, among these garbage knowledge, there is one, for example, the political knowledge from mainland China, Communist Party, teach us to learn these kind of things.
其实人在这个世界上最需要知道的知识是什么呢？
So actually, what is the most important knowledge we should learn in this world?
就是有关于自己是谁的知识。
It's about knowledge about who we are.
是关于我为什么要来到这个世界上的知识。
It's about why I'm here.
为什么会有这个世界，有这个宇宙，而不是没有呢？
Why the world, even the universe, is there? Why not this universe is not there?
为什么我们人类是人类和其他动物都不同呢？
Why we are human beings and we are utterly different from other animals?
但是可以告诉大家，最好的科学知识也只是给你描述一个过程。
But you have to know, to the best scientific knowledge, they only tell you how things work.
它可以告诉你现在是最盛行的在天体物理学上面的是我大爆炸的宇宙学。
They can tell you the best scientific cosmological knowledge called Big Bang Theory.
讲这个世界宇宙在160亿年之前在一次大爆炸中产生的。
They tell you that this world was there before 1.6 billion years before, come from a Big Bang.
但是当你了解了这大爆炸的这些科学叙述以后，你真正明白什么叫宇宙和世界存在了吗？
But once you learn this Big Bang theory, would you really know why this universe is there?
其实它只是告诉你世界为什么会出现成现在的样子，它只是告诉你的过程是怎么来的，它从来不能告诉你这世界为什么要来，为什么目的来，有什么价值。
Actually, the Big Bang Theory can only tell you how this world come into place, through what process is there, but they never tell you why this world is ever there, is there any purpose or destiny of this world.
就是比如关于人对人自己的来源的好奇心，人们想要知道人是怎么来的。
For example, we wonder why we are here. Where are we from?
到古代的话，那就通过这种好奇的猜测，就变成所谓的神话故事而已。
In ancient times, this kind of wondering turned to be myth.
比如说在中国的神话里面说天地怎么来的盘古造天地
For example, in Chinese myth, there's 盘古 opening up the heaven and earth.
那如果说人怎么来的女娲造了人
Where people come from, 女娲 made people.
但是人们都知道这不过只是人的一种神话性的解释而已没有人真的似乎把它当作真的东西
But everybody knows that this is a kind of myth. Nobody truly believe it.
但是所谓到了现代我们说我们现在有科学知识了一切都是以科学知识科学的说法为准我们难道真正得到什么真正有用的知识了吗
But nowadays things are different. We all believe something called scientific knowledge. But do we really make any progress?
比如说人需要知道人怎么来的
For example, we want to know why human beings are there.
所谓有一种科学理论就出现了这叫做进化论
So something called evolution showed up.
说世界上所有的事物都是从无机到有机然后产生单一的细胞比如说阿米巴虫是第一个所谓有生命的物质
So they say this world just started from non-organic to organic life For example, the amoeba animal that's a starting point of life
所以呢在这种情况下所有的生命好像都是从一个细胞以后逐渐分成多细胞然后产生各种各样种类的但是为什么会从一个细胞会发生这么多的生物种类？到底是为什么？
They say the theory says that all life come from one single cell and then divided into two, etc. But they never say why these one single animal will turn out to be all kinds of beautiful different types of animals and existence in this world now.
但是这种能够创造新物种的这种知识。从来只是一个假说只是用漫长漫长的时间里面好像是生物进化了最后怎么进化成什么样呢最后人是由某种猴子某种叫做特别叫类人猿的猴子把人给弄出来了
They use different ways to prove this kind of hypothesis, but finally they just come up with something like this. Human beings come from monkeys.
这种所谓的进化论要比这个宇宙大爆炸论是差得太远了。
These kind of evolution theories are far, far, far away from Big Bang theory.
因为宇宙大爆炸论还是有许多的先进的物理科学和各种实验的方面的指向告诉我们这个过程是可能是这样存在的。
Because the Big Bang theory do have strong scientific support to let us believe that this probably is the case.
但是生物进化论至于猿猴变成人了呢这完全永远根本实际上经不起任何严格的科学的检验当然不要说有实验来验证了永远不可能验证
But the biological evolution saying that human beings come from monkeys cannot withstand any kind of scientific proof
所以在这种情况下我们不能说现在科学发达了我们真的因此对我们人是谁世界为何要来我们人活在世上到底有什么意义和目的的话我们这个问题解决了没有呢
So we cannot say a so-called development of scientific knowledge Now we can know who we are Do we really know?
所以呢当代最杰出的科学家爱因斯坦曾经说如果你真要知道人生的意义的话请你不要问我这不是科学的事那是宗教方面的事
Even to the best scientist Albert Einstein used to say If you ask me things about life You are being religious
因为所有的科学解释都是无意义的解释无目的无意义无价值的解释只是一种机理的描述而已
Because all the scientific theories and explanations are without any meaning, no purpose, and they are just about mechanism and process.
我们人在这个世界上的命运其实要比任何一样，比如说我们人所造的东西都要惨。比如说茶杯，我们知道它为什么会存在在世界上，麦克风为什么存在世界上，因为它有它的作用，所以人要造出来。
Actually, the existence of us is much more complicated than the existence of a cup or a microphone. But for cup and microphone, we still know they are there because they have their purpose and function.
所以它是一种有目的的存在。
Therefore, they are there for a purpose.
但是如果世界呢，宇宙呢，它如果没有一个造物主的话，它就是一个无目的的存在。
But how about the universe? If there is no creator of it, then the universe is there without any meaning.
那么对于人呢，如果没有一个造物的上帝的话，我们人因为没有一个位格来具备的话，也是一个完全偶然的产物。
Including us, we human beings, if we are not made by a person, then we are just there without any meaning.
如果我们真的是一个 无次序的偶然的完完全全的没有目的的产物作为人的话，我们为什么一定要强调人活在这世上一定要寻找某种目的和意义呢？
If we are just here, actually without purpose, without cause, randomly, without order, then why we still ask the question, what's the meaning of life?
这就是其实人的一个大问题，人其实都不知道自己是谁，这件事情可严重了。
That's actually a huge problem. We don't know who we are. This is a serious problem.
我记得我那时候在知青联队插户，我知青联队那个时候插队落户的时候，第一次聚集有一个人被那个我那个所谓军代表，当时军代表他是管我们的，他报出来，他这个名字叫什么呢？他叫莫明生。
So when Pastor Hong was young, he served in the military, and there was a roll calling. Someone, a officer, called someone's name called IASH.
Well, I was not qualified to serve in military. Okay.我意思就是我那时根本不可能还没资格去参军。
Oh, sorry.
我是只是是在上山下乡当中，我们的领导是军队的。
Oh, thanks. So, sorry, my mistake. Pastor Hong was not serving the military, but the officer of the people he was with is from the military.
管我们知青的啊，他叫这个人叫，为什么大家会发生轰然大笑呢？
So why people laughed for the IASH?
因为他的名字表明他是一个莫名其妙的来到世界上的人。
Because that name means I am somehow here.
就是说他就所以大家觉得莫名生就是莫名其妙被生出来，觉得这个人这名字取得怎么这么搞笑呢
？So people laugh at him, says, "Hey, IASH, I am somehow here."
但是
What kind of name is this?
但是那些笑他的人都不知道，你笑他是莫名其妙来到世上，难道你就是有名有妙的就来到世上来了吗
？But when people laughing at that person, they didn't know. They actually don't know where they're there.
我们其实和他一样，我们都不知道为什么来到世上。
Actually, we are the same. We don't know why we are here.
当然，我们在国内是被教导说，我们的使命就是要预备好，将全就献给共产主义的壮丽事业。
Of course, in China, we have been brainwashed to believe that we are sacrificed for the communist mission.
这就是共产主义理论的一个破洞，它没有逻辑的。既然共产主义认为人是猴子变的，为什么猴子变成的人一定要去建设共产主义呢？
This is the Achilles heel of communism. It is that there's actually no meaning for human beings in their theory. But if there were no human meaning for human beings, then why we should contribute to communism?
所以，除非一群猴子说，其实我们应该建设共产主义，但是我们做猴子是无法做的。所以，让我们一起来变成人吧。变成人，我们就可以干这件事了。
Now, unless they say, oh, a group of monkeys says, as monkeys, we have no way to contribute to communism. So what do we do? Let's turn to human beings. Then we can do communism.
如果必须要说人生的必须有这个使命，因为你不做这个，不去干共产主义，你就是人类的敌人，就是公敌，就要被改造，就要被消灭，就根本不配做人啊！那就是做人的根本条件，就是要服从这个共产主义的呼召了。
So the communism present the meaning of life is that the only thing you should do in your life is to contribute to communism. Otherwise, you are just not human beings.
所以呢，这个世界上给我们的一种言说，其实都是无目的、无意。说到底，如果要涉及到价值和目的上，世界是没有资格说话的。
Therefore, whatever this world tells us, nothing is meaningful and nothing is purposeful. They cannot give us meaning and purpose.
为什么人会落到这么悲惨的地步呢
？Why we fall into such a desperate status?
因为人首先拒绝承认有一位造物主，有一位创天造地、创造生命的上帝存在。
Because first we refused to admit that there is an almighty creator who created the heavens and the earth.
但是人有没有这个感觉呢
But it isn't true that we have a feeling that he's there.
当我们把上帝给否认了，其实人就活在一种很荒谬的状态当中。
When we refuse the existence of God, we actually live in a confusion.
所以呢，在这儿呢，我要说明为什么人会处在这种荒谬当中，但是却不知道荒谬。这说明什么呢？这就是人的堕落。
So now I want to point out that when we are really in this confused status, but we didn't know that we are confused, this proves that we are in a fallen status.
所以就像那些搞创进化论的这些所谓的科学家，他告诉人，他说我们其实告诉了秘密，为什么我们坚持进化论啊？因为如果不坚持进化论，就必须承认有上帝了。
So actually, those scientists who believe and work on the evolution theory is actually working in such a way. They say, if we don't insist on evolution theory, then we have to believe the creation theory.
所以正好趁着大家都迷信科学的时代里啊，我们就打着科学的招牌，把进化论端出来，这样子呢，就可以把人对上帝的信仰从根子上拿掉。
They know now people all believe scientific knowledge. Therefore, they say, let's make use of science and let's make people go away from believing God and believe those evolution theory.
其实呢，圣经告诉我们啊，人如果要把神否定是根本其实是不可能的，是一种非常愚蠢的行为。
Actually, the Bible tells us that it is impossible for us to get rid of the sense of God. It is impossible.
比如说我们看翻开罗马书啊，我们翻开罗马书。
For example, let's see Romans.
罗马书一章十九节到二十一节我们来看一下啊。
Let's have a look at Romans 1:19-21.
首先十八章，因为这是福音的起头，保罗是怎么讲？首先讲上帝的愤怒显在一切不信他的人的身上。
First of all, Paul wrote that the wrath of God is on all the unrighteousness and the ungodliness of human beings.
然后呢，十九节就开始说了，神的事情人所能知道的，原来已经显明在人的心里了。
Then verse 19 says, "For what can be known about God is plain to human beings."
因为神为他们显明了。
Because God has shown it to them.
你不信的话，去查所有的远古的所谓的原始社会的这种遗迹啊，没有任何一个原始的社会，他们没有拜神的遗迹，都拜神的。
Go and check the geologists for the ancient relics. You can see there's no any ancient culture that nobody worships some gods.
人类哪怕他所有的知识在处于最低下的水平的时候，但他们一种事情知道的，那就是有神。
No matter how low human beings has low knowledge, but one thing is true that they always worshiped some gods.
就是说无论这个社会多少原始他都知道有神存在只是人 在原始的社会当中其实已经堕落了他只是搞不清哪一位是真正的上帝
Therefore, no matter how ancient the society was people has already know that there is some kind of God
如果说现代社会有什么进步就是把远古人他弄不清楚的上帝现在把他用科学呢清清楚楚地把他否定而已
So if we say there's any scientific progress in the modern society, we say people still don't know God, but they make the ancient gods to be not true God. They don't believe it.
因为接下来罗马书告诉，自从造天地以来，神的神性和永能是明明可知的。
Because afterwards, Romans says, for his invisible attributes, namely his eternal power and Divine nature has been clearly perceived even since the creation of the world.
虽然是眼不能见，但借着所造之物就可以晓得，叫人无可推诿。
We have said that.
所以在这里很重要，就是说，他不是要你去用证据来证明上帝存在，而是你拿不出证据来否定的上帝存在。
So it is not to make use of proofs to prove that God is there. Instead, it is that we have no evidence to deny the existence of God.
因为上帝已经给我们显明了，借着什么呢？借着他所创造的天地。
Because God has shown himself to us by what? By the heavens and earth he created.
因为天地宇宙是这样的井然有序，这样生命又是这么的复杂，你怎么能说这里面本身你了解宇宙和生命过程当中就发现里面是何等的精细深奥和智慧，那不是出于一个智慧的设计，难道是互相这些原子中所谓的随随便便的混乱的碰撞能够产生这一切吗？
Because heaven and earth are already greatly made there, and we see how complicated and wonderful and wise our human life is made. Can you believe that all of this is there because of some kind of atomic collision, and then we are somehow here?
所以在这里呢，人真是不可思议的，在这里的叛逆、愚蠢和荒唐。
So if people don't believe God, it shows that how rebellion, how stupid, how ignorant human beings are.
所以呢，接下来在罗马书说，为什么人会处在这种状态？
Then continues Romans tell us why human beings are like this.
保罗说，他们虽然知道神，却不感谢他，却不将不把他当作神来荣耀他，也不感谢他。他们的意念变为虚妄，无知的心就昏暗了。
Then Paul continually says that for although they knew God, they did not honor him as God or give thanks to him, but they became futile in their thinking and their foolish hearts were darkened.
所以今天我们的慕道朋友们，打开你们心门，一定要知道这一点，因为我们拒绝了上帝以后，我们的思念变为虚妄，无知的心就昏暗了。
So now, friends, new friends, you are not yet believing in the Lord. Open your heart. Understand this. If you keep in your unbelief, your heart will be darkened, and your thinking will be in futile.
那更悲惨的事情就是自己的这种黑暗、这种的无知，甚至都觉得习以为常，继续准备无目的、无计划的、无盼望的在这个世界上生活下去，直到这个。
The worst thing is that if you continue in your hardness and your unbelief and you feel that this is normal, you're going to continue living like this to the end of the world.
所以离开世界的言说，上帝怜悯他所创造的人，他要救一部分人成为他自己属于他的人的话，上帝就开始打破沉默发言了。
So because of the love and mercy of God, he led us to go away from the knowledge of the world. Now God starts speaking.
如果上帝不说，我们在这个黑暗中默说，是永远不知道世界是为着什么目的而来，人类为什么要被神所造，而人现在为什么处在这种混乱、痛苦、不满足的这种现象当中。
If God has never spoken, then we have no way to know where this world comes from, why we are here, and what's the meaning of life, and why people are wandering around and be sorrow and stressful for a whole bunch of different things.
所以呢，神就赐下了他的话语。
Therefore, God gave us His word.
所以，如果我们要知道世界的来源，人类生命的来源，那么我们首先要看创世纪。
So if you want to know where this world come from, where human life come from, we have to go to the book of Genesis.
所以上帝一上来就告诉我们，上帝是怎么样把这个世界预备的。
Then in the beginning, God tells us how God prepared this world.
当他上帝叙说他的世界怎么被预备的时候，他完全超越了人们的想象。
When God said how he prepared this world is utterly out of our imagination.
因为有很多古老的原始的神话也在说这个世界是怎么来的，也有各种创世的神话。
Because there are many ancient myths talking about the creation of the world.
所有的创世神话都是看到人眼睛看到的具体的东西是怎么来的。
But all of the myths are starting from things people can see.
比如说这个大山怎么生出来的，树林怎么出来的，动物怎么出来的，都是看得见的食物。
For example, it's all about what we can see. For example, how the mountains show up, how trees are there, how animals are there.
但是永远想不到这些东西要存在以前必须具备两个条件。
But they never think that in order for anything is there, there must be two conditions fulfilled.
因为所有的事物你看到的它必须都存在在时间和空间中。
Because everything exists in space and time.
空间你是空的你好像没有感觉是不是啊
For space, it looks like empty, and you have no feeling for it.
至于时间，你根本抓不住。所以，时间和空间，这是作为人类能够产生的一个舞台。如果先不搭建出来，人怎么能够出现在时空中呢
？Therefore, time and space is a kind of stage, in which human beings can be there.
所以，你从创世纪里，起初神创造天地里，把时间、空间都告诉你，都是他首先创造的。没有他，时间就不可能有个 beginning。
Therefore, the Bible starts saying that in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth, and we see that it is God who started the starting point of time. Without God creating time, it's impossible for anything to be there.
如果上帝不说他造了时间和空间的话，没有人想到有就是有造物主，也没有想到会造这两样东西，因为这完全超出人的想象的空间。
If God didn't say in the beginning He created the heaven and the earth, we have no way to realize that even a creator can create time and space.
另外，上帝告诉我们，他照着他的形象创造了人。
Another thing is that God tells us that He created us in His image.
所以在上帝创造的各类生命当中，人是最特别的一类，从来。因这么特别，所以不能用各从其类来说，而必须说人只是属于他的，因为有他的形象。
Therefore, among all the creations, human beings, we men have such a special status because God made us in His image. Therefore, we cannot be set into the category among other animals. We belong to God.
所以上帝创造了我们的始祖亚当夏娃，就给他们放在他自己的园子里，这叫伊甸园。
Therefore, when God created our first parents, Adam and Eve, He put them in His own garden, the paradise.
他的汗水、劳累、心思绝对不会是为他的生计操劳，因为上帝都供应了。
The effort of Adam and Eve are not for their own life because God has abundantly given them.
他供应到什么程度呢？就是你伸出手来抓住果子就可以吃的程度。请注意，那 totally organic. Okay.
God created in such a great way that just Adam and Eve stretch out their hands, they can get the fruits, and they're all organic.
所以啊，在这儿省掉了你最大的做厨房的工作，什么工作？都出了，让你做什么呢？专心的和他和上帝同行相处，多好啊！
Therefore, you didn't need to go to the kitchen to cook. All you need to do is just walk with God and have a good relationship with Him.
然后上帝分配你都是做大的事情，叫你管理这地，都是管理阶层的人。
And God assigned great jobs for Adam and Eve, led them to dominate the land.
然后修理看守他的园子，是为他的家做是一种最重要的复杂的这种荣耀的操作工作。
And to take care of God's garden and to be the steward, as such a glorious job.
所以他在那里的生活是非常，这个叫乐园，是愉快无忧无虑的，而且他享有最大的自由。
Therefore, they were there really in the paradise, the good garden of God, and they enjoyed the best freedom there.
但是上帝知道，上帝造的人不能给他只造成一种关系。上帝是人所有的愿望的供应商，想要什么，上帝就给你什么，然后给你做好保护，作为你的供应商，作为你的卫兵，最后上帝好像是围着你在安排生活。
But there is one thing must be added, otherwise God shall be just a supply of pleasures and desires of human beings. Whatever Adam and Eve they want, God just supply. It's look like they are God, but God is their servant.
但上帝造人是为着他的荣耀的目的，他是中心，人不是上成了 上帝反过来要服侍的中心，人反而要照出来要服侍上帝的。
But actually, God created human beings for His own glory, rather than center on human beings. Therefore, God must get the glory.
就像人现在造一切的东西，都是对人看来是有用的人才造，造出来的目的是为了人的好处、人的用处才造的，是不是啊？
Just like when now we make anything or we invent anything, we make them for our own goodness. We think they are useful, then we make them.
现在知道现在人也在造到现在人发生危机了。大家听说 AI 的 crisis 了吗？就是所谓人工智能的危险了吗？
Now, when we created many, many things, now we are in a crisis. Have you ever heard about the crisis of AI?
所以人至少现在要足够的意识到这危机了。现在一大批科学家、哲学家都被召集起来研究怎样防止造出来的 AI 人不能控制，反给人造成危害。
So now the AI crisis involved many scientists and philosophers. They put hard job there to think if the AI is out of humans' control, then we're in trouble.
如果我们知道它造了以后要我们围着它转，它不是为我们所用的，我们还会继续造吗？
If we make AI, but then it turned to be that AI is our center, then are we keep going making them?
所以我们想，我们如果人会这么傻的话，上帝也不会这么傻。
Then we think if we will not do that, then God will not do that.
所以上帝造了人，既供应人一切，是让人都得到他最大的满足的时候，一定要处理一件事情，就人跟上帝之间到底什么关系。
Therefore, as God has supplied everything human beings need, then God must do another thing, is to make the relationship between God and human beings right.
这就是说他要在伊甸园一定要设立上帝他自己的权柄的标志。
Therefore, God must put a sign for his sovereignty in the garden.
那就是什么呢？分别善恶树。
That is the true tree of the knowledge of good and evil.
因为这棵树是标志着上帝大而可畏的权柄，人不可能随便去触碰的。
Because this tree signifies the highest authority of God, and human beings are not allowed to touch it.
分别善恶是代表追溯于上帝的最终的审判权。
The knowledge and good and evil signifies the highest authority of God to judge good and evil.
这个权柄只能属于上帝，必须拿在上帝手里，且能给人拿过去，自己来分呢，自己来做判别呢。
This authority of judging and good and evil will be only belong to God, and human beings cannot take it.
但是这里千万不要误会了，难道上帝要我们不分好坏吗？不分黑白吗？
Do not be confused. Is that true that God doesn't want us to know good and evil?
正好相反，因为分黑白、分真理和谬误的事是最重要的，在上帝里面的事，所以这件事只能由上帝来分别。人必须听上帝怎么分别，人才怎么分别，人绝对不能自行的分辨。
Definitely not. Morally judging what is good and evil is essential in human life, but these judgments only belong to God. Therefore, we must follow how God judges good and evil.
所以如果人要自己来掌握这个，拿了这个果子自己来分辨的话，人就把自己当作上帝了。
Therefore, if human beings take that fruit of knowledge and good and evil and want to judge by themselves, they make themselves God.
那你就把上帝造人，同时要预备人引向良善的最重要的上帝的功能给剥夺了。
Then in doing so, you take away that most important part that how God make people really good.
所以呢，这就是当人听了蛇这个撒旦的诱惑去吃的时候，人就犯了严重的背离上帝的罪。
Therefore, that's why when Adam and Eve were deceived by Satan and took the fruit of the knowledge of good and evil, they committed this serious sin.
所以从这个角度来讲，人在这里。
Therefore, in this case, we know man here.
他就是在这里呢，要在这里要掌管他自己的所有的一切，在这里就是他自己的生命了。
Man here is just want to take control everything for their own good.
因为上帝说你吃的那日子就必死。
Because God said, the day you eat the fruit, you shall surely die.
为什么会死呢？
Why they will die?
不是那个果子本身有毒让你死。
It's not because that fruit is poisonous.
是因为你违背了上帝的话。
Because they disobeyed God's word.
所以人能活着不是单靠食物，要靠上帝口里所说的全部的话。
Therefore, man is not lived by bread alone, but by every word that is from the mouth of God.
所以我们的始祖首先就破除了不听上帝的话。结果他想再吃果子，他其实也就没有机会再吃了。
Therefore, our first parents, they first disobeyed God, they rebelled, then they have no more chance to eat the real fruits.
撒旦把人引诱到与上帝创造人的目的相对立的地步，就是向上帝宣战。
Satan deceived the human beings to go the opposite of God's direction of human life, that is to fight against God.
所以上帝就必须有他自己的自卫反击战。
Therefore, God will defend himself.
大家知道，现在战争当中，你动手先去打人的往往是侵略的一方，你自卫反击就会得到他应当有的正当性，是不是？
Now we know if nowadays if a nation attacks another, that's wrong. But if a nation defends itself, that is right.
所以上帝必须捍卫自己的创造秩序，捍卫自己的创造和掌管的权柄。
Therefore, God must defend the creation he created and the highest authority belong to himself only.
上帝必须让撒旦这个计谋完全的被他审判破除。
God must judge and defeat Satan completely.
所以这就是我们今天在创世纪的三章十四、十五节读到的话。
This is what we read in Genesis 3, 14 and 15.
所以上帝首先就是审判了那撒旦，让他终身吃土。
So first of all, God judged that serpent to let the serpent eat dust all the days of his life.
就是让他做了这件事情以后，让他的所有原来创造的荣耀，创造他过去的荣耀全部把它剥夺了。
That is, because the serpent did this, all the glory belonged to the serpent's creation is all taken away.
然后上帝就在十五节里面就告诉上帝要做什么事呢？上帝要叫他和女人彼此为仇。
Then in verse 15, God said that the offspring of the serpent will fight with the offspring of the woman.
你的后裔和女人后裔也彼此为仇。
Your offspring will have enmity with the offspring of the woman.
女人的后裔要伤你的头，你要伤她的脚跟。
Her offspring will crash your head, and you will hurt his heel.
首先，他讲这个撒旦要和女人彼此为仇。首先，这个女人是谁
？First of all, who is this woman?
然后，他的后裔，女人的后裔又是谁
？Then, who is the offspring of the woman?
这就成了一个。我们读圣经，很多人读到这儿就变成一个千古之谜了，女人的后裔之谜，到底女人是谁？女人的后裔又是谁呢
？Then many people stuck here. Who is the woman? Who is the offspring of the woman?
好，我先在铺垫以前，我先讲出来，这女人就是上帝要招来的属他的百姓的全体，这就是这个女人。
So first of all, Pastor Hong will point out that this woman is the whole collection of God's people.
在古代，这个女人的名字叫做以色列。
In the ancient time, the name of the woman is called Israel.
在现代，我们在末世，我们讲在末世，我们把这个女人的名字叫做教会。
Now is called the last days. The name of this woman is called the church.
所以我们教会在这里聚集成为上帝的儿女，那么撒旦一定会跟什么我这个女人要去征战的。
Therefore, we church collected as God's sons and daughters, then Satan must fight with us, the woman.
但是请注意，女人的后裔一定能够取得这场征战的最后胜利。
But notice, the offspring of the woman will definitely win.
所以我既说了女人是谁以后，然后说女人的后裔是从哪里产生的，我们现在就明白了。
Now we know who is the woman, then we know where the offspring of the woman come from.
首先大家知道伊甸园以后啊，这些人呢，亚当夏娃就被赶出了伊甸园。
First of all, we know after Adam and Eve fall in the Garden of Eden, they were expelled from the garden.
上帝开始准备他的女人的过程也开始了。
God started his preparation of the offspring of the woman.
当然这个女人不是夏娃，因为她是当时上帝造的第一个女人，唯一的女人，以为她这个女人指她自己。
But notice this woman doesn't mean that's Eve, although Eve was the only woman there.
他们被赶出来以后，当然心里非常郁闷。她后来生了一个孩子叫 Gavin， 她说就是她了，这就是我的后裔，将来一定要报你一箭之仇，你撒旦你小心点。
When they were expelled from the Garden of Eden, and they got a son called Cain, and the woman Eve was very excited, saying, "Ha, this is the offspring. Satan, you're done."
但是我们读圣经发现故事的发展正好相反。
But when we read the Bible, we find the story is the opposite.
该隐代表着蛇的后裔。
Cain represents the offspring of the serpent.
他首先造成以他儿子以诺的名字来命名他，就表示人的雄心，叫自己创造自己在地上的，不需要上帝的业结，作为人的自豪。
He first of all named the city by the name of his son Enoch, showing that he is exalting people's name to the highest.
所以他这个该隐又杀害了他的弟弟亚伯。
And this Cain then murdered his younger brother Abel.
但是上帝一定在这里不会等闲视之的。
But God will not ignore it.
所以呢，上帝又为他预备了一个叫赛特的。
Then God prepared another son called Seth.
就借助赛特这条线和该隐这条线，已经开始了。女人的后裔和蛇的后裔的征战。
Then God established these warfare between the offspring of the woman and the offspring of the serpent in the line of Seth and the line of Cain.
但是蛇的后裔势力很大。
But the offspring of the serpent is very severe and great.
蛇本身它属灵的，它是一个属灵的邪灵啊，它不会真的生什么后裔。但是以撒旦作父的，就不信神为自己父的人。都成了蛇的后裔了。
Satan himself is an evil spirit. He cannot get some fleshy offspring. But all those unbelievers didn't believe God. They belong to the offspring of serpent.
以至于他们怎么样啊？他们控制了，他们控制什么？控制了整个世界，除了一家人以外。
To the degree that all of these offspring of the serpent took control of the whole world, except for one family.
因为圣经说世上的人都在做心里想的都是，所以上帝决定只把诺亚一家救出来，把其他的该隐的后裔全部扫除了，只留赛特的其中的一个后裔，那就是诺亚和他的一家。
Because God saw that every human being in his heart is thinking about evil, then God said he will wash away all human beings except for just one person.Who is the grand-grand-grandson of Seth called Noah.
所以上帝啊，务必除恶，斩草除根的这个心是很大的，千万不要小看上帝的，他就是烈火。你千万不要说我跟多数人在一起，我跟世界很像，就保险了，没这回事。
So we can see that God is a holy God. He has nothing to do with sin, and he is fire. He will burn out all sins. Therefore, if you think that you will belong to many, many people in the world, you are wrong.
但是上帝借把诺亚一家救出来，就跟诺亚订约，这叫做诺亚彩虹之约。
But when God saved Noah and his family, God established a covenant with Noah that is called a covenant of rainbow.
这个彩虹之约，我们也就是上帝的普遍恩典，要保留这地，直到他再来。现在先把这个地和人都先保留下来。
This covenant of rainbow is called common grace, is that God will preserve the heaven and earth for human beings.
当诺亚这一家又开始发展出来的时候，
When Noah's family keep developing,
但是上帝就看到了，把闪的后裔先分开。
Then God decided to separate the family line of Shem.
所以呢，那个时候世人罪恶又开始了，几乎世界上都在一起啊。他们所建立巴比塔，就是要传扬人的名。要跟上帝较劲，免得我们被分散在各地，因为上帝的命令是要他们分散。
Then the people continually in sin again, and they build something called the Tower of Babel. They want to exalt their name to the highest, and they don't want to spread it out in all the earth according to God's word. They want to be just there.
但是就在这个时候，上帝就用辩论他们的语言，把他们分散，使他们不能造那个塔和城，把人所谓的盼望的大一统全部把它粉碎。
Then at that moment, God confused their languages so that they are no longer able to build up their tower, and they cannot stay in one place, and they have to be spread out in all of the world.
所以啊，大家想象啊，所谓那个是造巴别塔的时候，那个时候全民是众志成城，同心同德，就是一起来创造建设，这不就是人类的梦寐以求今后的大同世界呢？
Think about when people was building the Tower of Babel, everybody is doing one thing, everybody has the same heart, they are contributing in the same project. Isn't true that that's just like the big project of all human beings?
所以从人的角度怎么看都是一件最好的事情。
So it seems like from the point of view of human beings, it's kind of a bad thing.
这就是圣经必须从上帝来的最重要的明证。这件事情在上帝是最恶的事情。
However, this is the worst thing and the most evil thing in God's eye. This is in the Bible, God's word.
所以上帝辨认他们语言以后，使他们不能同工了，所以他们被迫本来把上帝的祝福变成上帝的审判，分散在各地，从此民族国家产生了。
Therefore, when God confused their language, they are no longer to work on this project altogether. They have to be separated to everywhere in the world, and they became all different nations.
所以我告诉大家，任何在这个世界上，任何民族国家都是在罪中产生的。
So therefore, I tell you, all nations in this world came from evil.
所以上帝就像我们现在一人一张神话语读到今天读到诗篇第二篇了。受膏者要拿起铁杖打碎列国的一切的这种瓦器，全部要各国的君王都要受审判。
So as we read the scripture Psalm 2 today, that the anointed will take up his iron rod and breaking up all the nations in the world.
所以你就不应该称为有稀奇了，因为世界上所谓的民族主义，所谓的爱国主义。都要把自己的国家民族看成是特殊比别的民族更优秀的都是这个世界最可怕的形成战争根源的恶毒的来自撒旦的邪说
Then you know all the nationalism or patriarchalism they want to exalt their nations and their people to the highest in the world they initiated wars they come from sin
所以因此在这个情况下面神怎么办难道上帝为他要造女人建立他的女人要然后要使这个女人有后裔的计划就破产了吗
Then under this condition, what God will do? God promised that a woman will have offspring. Will God's promise fail?
所以经过这两次审判以后上帝开始真正动工了
So after these two judgments, God initiated his work.
所以创世纪十二章这一章是转折性的那一章里面上帝把亚伯拉罕从万民当中也是从他原来造偶像的民族当中把他一家一个人把他招出来
So starting from Genesis 12 God started his work He called out that man Abraham and his family belong to God himself
因为上帝要通过他的后裔把他的女人造出来
Because God will make use of the offspring of Abraham to call the offspring of the woman.
而亚伯拉罕作为他的女人的第一个的代表的话，上帝要的不是别的，就是完全的信心。
Then Abraham, as the first representative of the offspring of the woman, God wants himself nothing but faith.
所以我今天来讲的传讲的福音是世界上除世界上的知识以外的另一套。奥秘的体系，他的体系不是要你怎么样下苦功去学，而是要凭信心去领受。
Therefore, the gospel Pastor Hong preached today is not like those knowledge in the world that you have to learn, but this is a knowledge that you have to believe by faith.
只要你相信我今天所讲的信息不是从人手造出来的，不从世界出来的话，你就知道上帝是那真实的上帝。你要做的事情就是学亚伯拉罕，当亚伯拉罕叫上帝叫亚伯拉罕，你要离开父家本地本族跟我前行，亚伯拉罕就跟他走了。
So now, if you believe this message, you are going to know this message is not from the world, but is from God. Then all you need to do is just like Abraham, what you do is that you go from your country and your kindred and your father's house to the land that I will show you.
因为上帝叫亚伯兰走的一个很大的目的是说，我要你使你成为大国，我要使你的名为大，我要让地上的万族都是要因你得福。
Because the purpose of God's calling of Abraham is that God will make of you a great nation, and I will bless you and make your name great, so that you will be a blessing.
亚伯兰这时候已经75岁了，连个孩子没有，他怎么能让万族都从他这里得福？从何谈起啊？
But Abraham was there 75 years old yet, and he didn't have a son. Then how come he become a blessing of many nations?
然后我们就读到了上帝赐给他，在100岁的时候赐给他的一个儿子叫以撒。
Then we read that God gave Abraham a son when he was 100 years old.
然后说只有从以撒出来的才成为你的后裔。
This son is called Isaac, and God said the son come from Isaac will called your offspring.
上帝明明告诉他我要赐给你这个孩子，让你的后裔通过以撒才是你的后裔的话，但是为什么上帝又叫亚伯兰把以撒献给他成为燔祭呢？
Since God said that a son come from Isaac will be called your offspring, but why God called Abraham to sacrifice his only son Isaac?
这是从人的任何的逻辑上面是想不通的，从道德上来讲也是更不可能的事情。难道上帝真要烧掉唯一给我的儿子吗？
We cannot understand this, no matter logically or morally. Is it true that God wants me to sacrifice my only son?
但是不管怎么样，亚伯拉罕就这样做了。
But no matter what, Abraham did it.
为什么呢？
Why?
因为在这里带出了几个很重要的信息。
Because here are many, many messages, important messages belong to it.
因为首先上帝要他做的时候不是在亚伯拉罕当初被他招的时候，而是跟随了很长一段时间，到100岁以后，亚伯拉罕的生命已经有这样的成长，上帝才给他下这个命令。
First of all, God didn't call Abraham to do this when Abraham first followed God, but it's after Abraham has followed God for many years, when he was 100 years old, then God called him to do this.
所以在这里，上帝要试验亚伯拉罕，试验他的信心。也是试验他的爱心，对上帝的完全无保留的敬畏之心。亚伯拉罕，你有没有
？Therefore, here God is testing Abraham, is to test Abraham's faith, and his love is supremely given to God, because whether Abraham is truly fearing God is tested here.
第二点叫引出一个关于死人还能复活的这么一个奥秘。
Second is to bring out a mystery that the dead can be resurrected.
因为就像希伯来书11:19曾经提到过一样，因为亚伯兰信仰，既然上帝说只有通过以撒的后裔才是你的后裔的话，那么以撒是不可能真的死，因为这时候以撒还没有成婚，还没有留下任何后裔。
It just like Hebrews 11:19 says, in order for Abraham to truly have a son and become a great nation, that son must survive, because right now Abraham didn't have other sons.
因为上帝绝不可以把他自己的郑重的应许当中撕毁，不可能的。
Because God will definitely not stop and throw away his important promise.
那么既然不可能又说要把它献了，那么怎么使这个不可能成为可能呢？亚伯拉罕想，可能就是他虽死了，上帝还可以叫他重新活过来。
Since God has promised Abraham to have these sons, Isaac, and then God surely command Abraham to sacrifice his son, then Abraham thought the only option is that his son will be resurrected from the dead.
所以呢，请注意，上帝没有让他的儿子死而复活，因为这个死而复活是留给上帝的真儿子，不是亚伯拉罕的儿子，这是以后的事，但是已经指向了将来。
Notice God at that moment didn't really resurrect Abraham's son from the dead. Instead, this event in history is pointing to the resurrection of the true son of God in the future.
通过亚伯拉罕献祭的第三个意义什么呢？就引出了有羔羊可以把你从死亡本来的危险当中替换出来的这么一个救恩的奥秘。
The third point of the sacrifice of Abraham's son is that a lamb can substitute and to be atonement for someone is in trouble. The lamb can die for a person.
所以这个上帝要为他造一个女人的计划是不能够被解除的。亚伯拉罕的后裔的契合就是上帝的那位女人。而这个女人是一定要留下来的，是怎么留下来？是靠着上帝所设立的代赎，用羔羊来换下来，使她存活下来。
Therefore, this offspring of God, of the woman must be survived. He cannot die because God's promise must come true. Therefore, there is going to be a lamb to die for this offspring of the woman.
所以我们今天作为教会我们能够活下来，因为上帝不会让他的女人消失，而是用他的方法把我们保存下来的。
Therefore, we as church, we will not disappear, because we as the woman, God will surely sustain us by His mean.
所以在二十二章里面最重要的一句话，因为你啊，我士大夫给你，因为你把你的独一生的爱子你也给了我，就说明我们对上帝的爱要到这个程度。因着是这样，你要多大的信心啊？那么因此上帝就有应许了。
Therefore, the most important message in chapter 22 of Genesis is that since Abraham did not keep his only son without sacrificing to God, then God will definitely keep his promise to Abraham.
所以在第十八节的时候，上帝就说出他的话来了。
Therefore, in verse 18, God said,
地上的万国都必因你的后裔得福。
All the nations of the earth will be blessed in your offspring.
你看，在这里面，亚伯拉罕的后裔可以用复数的集体名词解释，也可以用单数的个人的方面来解释。
You see, the offspring of the woman can be interpreted both in singular and plural.
因为上帝保守了他所招来的他的选民，而他选民一定会给提供一个他所要的那个后裔。
Because God will definitely keep all the people He called, and these people will be provided by the one offspring of the woman.
所以十二章创世纪十二章说万国都因你得福，现在到二十二章终于明白了，是因你的后裔得福，因为这个就是上帝的救恩计划。
Now we know when Genesis 12 promised that all the nations shall be blessed through Abraham, and in chapter 22 we know now this blessing is actually come through the offspring of Abraham, his son.
所以在这儿啊，因为你听从了我的话，就是一个亚伯拉罕的信的最高表达。
So here God said, because you obeyed my word. This is the expression of Abraham's faith.
因为亚伯拉所听从上帝的话是每一句，包括最困难的要把他儿子献出来的那句话都包括进去了，这才叫听从。
Because Abraham's obedience to God's voice includes every word of God, including the most harsh word Abraham still followed.
因着这样的信，他就成为我们的信心之父。我们就因这儿，我们就一起照着亚伯拉罕信心，我们就得救了。这叫因信称义。
Because of this kind of faith, Abraham becomes our father of faith, and we follow him in such same faith.
这对我们弟兄姐妹是很好提醒啊，有很多人信主以后本来啊不认识神的话，现在有很多话都听了。
So this is a good reminder for brothers and sisters here, because once we believe the Lord, we may follow few of God's word, but now we obey more of God's word.
但不是全部的话哦。
But not yet all the word of God.
有些话你觉得跟你造成了你非常的不方便，你非常不情愿啊！你说上帝啊，我大部分都听了，就这个你就放宽了，让我照我的意思做就是了。
But there are some words of God is really hard to follow. You may think that, oh, the most of your word I've followed, but just give me an easy time on these words.
所以这要当心，这是会形成一个破口。这个破口，撒旦就趁虚而入，把我们捣毁。
Be careful. There is going to be a breaking point, a very dangerous breach there for Satan to destroy all of you.
因为上帝跟亚伯拉罕立约的时候说，他怎么说呢？我是完全的，你也必须完全。
Because when God establishes His covenant, He said, "I am God Almighty, therefore be blameless."
所以正因为这样，所以上帝允许国度从你而来，君王从你而出。
Therefore, because of this, God promised that nations will come from you and kings will come from you.
我要做你和你后裔的神，做永远的约。
I will be God of you and your offsprings as a covenant forever.
这就解释了为什么上帝所设立的婚姻，神所配的人不可分开的根本的奥秘。
This explains the very mystery why the marriage God put together cannot be separated.
所以上帝把借助亚伯兰的后裔把他召起来，要。成为一个上帝的百姓的群体的时候，上帝就把这个过程就认为上帝在地上聘了以色列成为他的妻子。
So when God collected all His people in Abraham and established His covenant with His people, this is like God has married His church on earth.
所以这个约是上帝是所以我是所以上帝是彼此互相忠贞的一个约，谁都不应该违反的，一违反就约就破了。
So this covenant is that we belong to God and God belong to us as our God, and this is an unbreakable covenant. If any part break it, it's no longer a covenant.
所以我们读旧约的时候就知道以色列会受很多的苦，上帝要鞭打他，因为他去效法，他违背了对上帝的专一的忠心，他也拜其他民族的偶像。
That's why when we read the Old Testament, we find that the old Israel, they went through so many hardships and difficulties because they didn't follow God wholeheartedly. Rather, they bow down to many other idols.
所以在这里，在何西亚书里面，我们就看到二章十九节有一句特别的话。
So here we see in the book of Hosea, chapter 2, verse 19.
他说，我必聘你，永远归我为妻。
God says, and I will betroth you to me forever.
以仁义、公平、慈爱、怜悯聘你归我。
I will betroth you to me in righteousness and in justice.
以诚实来聘你归我。
In steadfast love to betroth you to me.
你就必认识我耶和华。
And you shall surely know me, the Lord.
所以今天我们真的是要呼召，就是让我们来听福音，就是让我们让上帝成为你的上帝。你要成为上帝的他的百姓，成为从某种角度成为上帝的妻，是他的心腹。
So now, when you hear the gospel, you just want God to be your God, and you become God's people, and in some sense, you become like a wife of God, and you will show your highest faithfulness to God.
所以这个时候，我们在约翰福音里看到耶稣在井边跟撒玛利亚妇人谈的时候。就说到这句话，说我们所拜的，我们知道，因为救恩是从犹太人出来的。
Therefore, when we see in John, the Gospel of John, when the Lord Jesus preached to the Samaritan woman, he said, "We know whom we worship because salvation is from the Jews."
因为上帝借着犹太人准备了救恩。
Because God used the Jews to prepare His salvation.
这个救恩是怎么准备出来的呢？
How did God prepare the salvation?
就是让他的儿子 在犹太人的群体里面取了肉身。
Is that God made his own son to get the flesh as an offspring of Jews?
当然从某种意义上玛利亚是童女怀孕从圣灵感孕耶稣来到世上他完完全全是只从女人这里出来的。
Now, Mary gave birth to Jesus as a virgin. Therefore, we know Jesus is born by virgin.
所以无论从象征的意义还是 literally, 他耶稣是女人的后裔。只有他配有这个资格成为真正的女人的后裔。
Therefore, no matter symbolically or literally, Jesus was born by a virgin.
因为救恩基督是从犹太人被准备出来的。
Because salvation belonged to the Jews.
所以耶稣必须是犹太人。
Therefore, Jesus must be Jews.
所以耶稣必须是出自于上帝的立约的那个群体当中，是上帝从幼年所聘的妻子里面所生养出来的那位。
Therefore, Jesus must be the offspring of that virgin woman God married when the woman was a virgin who was faithful to God.
好，这是讲到现在都是创世纪，是不是啊？
Therefore, now we are all talking about Genesis.
让我们穿越时空，一下子到了圣经的最后的启示录。
Let's go through time and to the end of the Bible, Revelation.
因为启示录把这个女人的身份真正给我们这里显明了。
Because in Revelation, we truly know who this woman is.
因为在启示录最后一卷书当中，在上帝的最后审判当中，告诉我们上帝的女人的后裔是怎么来的，是撒旦是怎么要来除灭她，最后失败的。这就是我们今天最后我们一起读的这段经文。大家一起来念好不好？请。
Great sun appeared in the heaven, a woman clothed with the sun, with a moon under her feet, and her head a crown of 12 stars. She was pregnant and was carrying out in birth pains and agony of giving birth. And another sign appeared in heaven. Behold, a great red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns, and on his head 7 diadems.The tail swept down a third of the stars of heaven and cast them to the earth. And the dragon stood before the woman who was about to give birth, so that when she bore her a child, she might devour it. She gave birth to a male child, one who is to rule all the nations with a rod of iron, but her child was caught up to God and to his throne. And the woman fled into the wilderness, where she has a place prepared by God.In which she is to be nourished for 1,260 days.
感谢神的话，神的话是当称颂的。
Thanks be the Lord. The Lord's word should be praised.
所以我们弟兄姊妹在我们信友堂查过的启示录很熟了这段话，但是我们的慕道朋友我要解释一下，从这二章的一节开始，说天上出现出个大异象来，有一个妇人。身披热头，脚踏月亮，披热踏月的，说明他在在世界上的位置是何等的什么宝贵，但是你还不知道这个妇人怎么有这么大的荣耀。但是下面说他带十二星的冠冕，你就知道他是代表哪一个族群了，他就是以色列。
Now we see this woman's clothed with sun and with moon under her feet. She must be very royal and in a high status in the world. But who she is? Once we see on her head a crown of 12 stars, we know this woman is Israel.
好，第二节我们看啊，这个妇人怀了孕，在生产的艰难中疼痛呼叫，代表什么意思呢？
And we see second verse, she was pregnant and was crying out in birth pains and the agony of giving birth. What does this mean?
大家知道创世纪的时候大家又搞不懂了为什么耶和华宣判女人必须受生养的痛苦。
We remember in Genesis 3, God promised that the woman must go through the pain of childbirth.
当然 literally 实际上也是真的，我们女人怀孕生子要比其他任何动物生他们的后代都要显得更加痛苦。
Now we know this is literally true. When a mom gives birth to a child, is more painful than any other animals in the world.
但是它真正的属灵意义在这里展现了。
But here is the true spiritual meaning of it.
为什么他在生产的艰难中疼痛呼叫呢？因为以色列被上帝的带领过程，直到他被鞭打，最后回归，最后要生养出耶稣基督来，这个过程，这个历史可不是容易过来的。
She was impregnant and was in birth pain because Israel went through so many trials and distress and difficulties and disciplines from God until Jesus came.
但是他的奥秘就是，无论他如何被折磨，如何被打倒，如何被管教，但他永远不会被毁灭。
But the mystery is that no matter how Israel was disciplined and painfully rotted, Israel will never disappear.
想想吧，在以色列周边的所有这些国家，哪一个国家不毁灭了呢？都毁灭了，都没有他们真正的子孙在。
Think about all the nations surrounding Israel. They are all disappeared. They are not there. They don't have their offsprings in the world now.
亚述在哪里？巴比伦在哪里？推罗在哪里？你随便数好了，摩押在哪里？他们都不见了，民族都没有这个身份了。
Where is Babylon? Where is Assyrian? Where is Moab? Where is Tarat? All disappeared. No offsprings of them exist right now in the world.
哦，这时候你会说，不，埃及不还在吗？埃及，告诉我，现在的埃及不是那时候的埃及。
Oh, you may say, oh, Egypt is there. No, the Egypt now is not the Egypt there.
因为现在的埃及人是阿拉伯人，不是当时的埃及人。当时的埃及人作为一个民族消失了。
Because the people in Egypt now are Arabians, they are not the ancient Egypt people. The ancient Egypt people was no longer there now.
曾经攻打过以色列的国家民族没有一个生存下来。
All nations have ever attacked Israel disappeared.
哪怕他盛极一时。
No matter how great they were.
哪怕以色列灭过了两次，以色列仍然还在。
Even Israel was totally destroyed twice, but Israel is still there now.
因为上帝的目的还没完成。
Because God's purpose has not yet achieved.
当在以色列出了耶稣以后，
as long as Israel gave out Jesus.
所以以色列作为上帝的群体的立约的群体的历史就此结束了。
Then the history of Israel as God's covenant of people ended.
现在上帝的心腹是荣耀的名字，就是我们教会。
Now God's wife, the glorious wife, is us, the church.
因为很清楚，你继续看下去，这个孩子他到了哪里了呢
？It's very clear. Now we see where this offspring of the woman go.
你的 PPT 在往下放的时候就看见了，撒旦是要对付他，撒旦得逞了吗？没有，最后这个男孩到哪里去了？到了上帝的宝座了，他得胜。升天，还要再来。
We see where this son goes. Satan want to destroy him, but did Satan succeed? No. Where did son go? He went to heaven.
从巴比塔审判当中出来的万国、立国都要被这个孩子用铁杖来管辖。
All the nations coming from the rebellion of the Tower of Babel shall be disciplined by the rod of this son.
所以他被提到神的宝座那里去了。
Therefore, he was led to the throne of God.
然后呢？然后呢？然后就撒旦开始要迫害已经生了耶稣的那个群体。这个群体叫什么呢？就是教会。
Then Satan will persecute that group of people saved by the Son, which is called the church.
现在的教会在哪里？在旷野里。
Where is the church now? She's in the wilderness.
她不在世界上。
She's not in the world.
她还没有进入。神要给他预备的最后的家。
She has not yet entered into the eternal home God prepared.
他就像当初的以色列还未进迦南地，在旷野中受试炼。
She is like the ancient Israel in the wilderness before coming to the land of Canaan.
那时候被召的多，真正进迦南的有多少
？There were many people called in Israel, but how many really got into Canaan?
这就是我们今天在这里把福音从。创世纪开始用启示录主启示录把一个上帝借着亚伯拉罕之约要准备的那个女人的后裔耶稣向大家显明出来
This is what our message today Starting from Genesis to Revelation God prepared that offspring of the woman through the covenant God established with Abraham
所以你要知道整个从旧约创世纪到启示录最后完成这个过程它经过了多少呢
Therefore, we know, starting from Genesis all the way to Revelation, how long did it take?
差不多经过了三千年。
It's about 3,000 years.
从第一卷到现在最后六十六卷，全部解说，那不是一个人，任何人在任何时候能够把这个非常的精妙、精确、完美的这个上帝的机制给我们，让我们知道，除非最后的作者是他自己，都是他的话。
Starting from the first book all the way to the 66th book, no any human person is able to compile and come up with such a perfect and deliberate and a fantastic book to tell us God's entire plan of salvation for us.
所以今天听了这篇信息的，如果慕道的朋友，你不能反驳，不是人手所造，不是人的传说，是真的。你要好好的在此地要祷告了，我们也为你祷告，希望在下面两次的我们的信息当中，我要奉神的名将你呼召出来。
So friends, once you heard today's message, you will surely know this is not the message from the world. This is indeed the message from God. The next two messages, Pastor Hong will call you out to be God's people.
让我们一起低头祷告。
Let's pray together.
亲爱的阿爸天父，我们感谢赞美你，我们谢谢你今天给我这么一个机会，在这里将你整全的福音的奥秘在这里融贯的一致的在这里和盘的突出，你所要的为你自己的女人的后裔，从创世纪开始所说的这句话，整本圣经就是为了这个实现这个目的而来做的。主啊，让我们今天才知道原来圣经是如此的一字有据、完整、严谨。主啊，因为它完完全全以你的荣耀为中心，而在这里能够支持我们世人，我们在自己的麻木当中，我们在无知当中，我们在黑暗当中，我们甚至都不知道自己的身份，不知道来到自己的世界的目的，如果还至于巴比塔审判的某国某座的人为自己的骄傲和荣耀，那是必定逃脱不了审判的命运的。主啊，愿你把他们都呼出来，就像你把福音曾经到过各国，因为万国的人要因你的后裔得福，其中一定包括我们来自中国的人。主啊，我们在这里将我们的同胞、将我们的弟兄姊妹在此献在你的坛前，求你的恩典怜悯不离开他们，在这个福音营的这三天两夜当中，你的圣灵时时动工，借着我们各场聚会，借着我们的分组讨论，借着我们的晚上的祷告，借着明天的晨祷会，每一件每一个信息以至下午的问题解答，都来指向一个目标，就是将世上的灵魂被拯救出来归给你，不再被撒旦，不住在撒旦的国度里面遭受那最后的可怕的审判。主，谢谢你听我们祷告，奉主耶稣基督名求，
Amen, Amen.